All right. So, I just wanted to title this video, Slavery Never Ended. It just got rebranded. Also, it seems that colonialism is still at play. Okay? Now, first I'm going to talk about this COVID shot. Okay? I understand COVID is very real. I'm not one of these people that, oh, it's not real, it's a conspiracy, because I had it, okay? With that being said, I am highly pissed off that the government, and when I say the government, the people at large, these descendant of the slave master, these colonialists, I don't care about the few sprinkling the black and brown because it's not enough of them there, okay? The majority of them are descendants of slave masters, former slave masters, slave owners, and colonialists, okay? Not only that, the majority of people, which are a minority, a small amount of wealthy, super wealthy Caucasian families, okay, that own all the industries in America, the airline industry, the hospital industry, the food service industry, the automobile industry, you name it. It's a small group of families, whether they're 13 families, 10 families, however, these are all Caucasians, okay, whose ancestors made their wealth from slavery and colonialism. And so they can hire people still at slave wage. I drove by McDonald's the other day and I just can't get off their tip. You know what I'm saying? And I'm gonna share a download that I got from the mother. First of all, let me share the download now. The mother, I was in meditation the other day and I was just really pissed off and I was in deep transcendental meditation. And she said one day, I don't know how soon, okay, McDonald's and places like that, they're gonna have to start paying people $30 an hour to come in there and work for them. Now, you can't see it now because, you know, I was driving by the other day and they had the fucking audacity to put up $12 an hour, $13 an hour, and for a manager, $15 an hour with experience. I'm sorry, but that's money you pay a high school student getting their first job. How you gonna look at a grown-ass adult with bills, children, and give them a punk-ass $15 an hour while your franchise is making millions of dollars a month from people coming in, breakfast, lunch, and dinner, all day people are coming in and you're making money. And the people at the top, the people who they, you know, their little managers and whatnot, you know, people are working for nothing. Now, you know, I'm trying to calm myself because I am just in a mood where I am just enraged and just pissed off because honestly, I'm tired of this. And see, this empire here, we've already got the download. It's going to fall. In the future, America won't be the place that people will be rushing to come to because it's literally going to damn near empty out. The original indigenous people are going to have their country back because you know what? The so-called third world countries, which are the first world countries, those are the economies that's going to be booming. And that's where people are going to be. Not this here, because this here is going to fall on its sword, its own sword of wickedness. This is why in this age of Aquarius, we have got to go back to working with Saturn. Never mind the patriarchal hysteria that's been attached to Saturn by the Islamic and the Hindu groups and all of these other groups that Saturn, you know, is death and cold. And yes, she is death. She is also an ancestor. Saturn is our ancestor, okay, that governs all the other six planets. And this is why in the so-called age of Aquarius, the return of the crone mother Saturn, this is where we have got to get into working with Saturn, because see, Saturn is going to be the one that bring about this justice. That is, you know, this imbalance that have gone on for so long. And it's just all over the place. Okay? You look at this COVID shot that they're trying to force on people. Now, you tell me, in this day and age, in 2021, why the hell it is the government, who's a minority, feel that they can impose their will on the majority? Now, people have all right not to trust your ass, given the medical apartheid, the germ, biological and chemical warfare that has been used against indigenous people since, you know, these raggedy ass Europeans brought their ass over here and stole the land, okay, and got their hands in everybody else's economy, despite the fact that they are a minority on the planet. Even though the census lie and say that they're a majority in America, they are not. They're a minority. Always have been, always will be, and are dwindling, might I add. In 200 more years, they won't even be here, okay? And this is not about black and white, okay? This is just about what it is. Because it's not just my being pissed off, it's an ancestral pissed off at the continued inequality of a small group of people that got all the wealth, okay? And that the majority of the people are out here overworked and underpaid. What's happening now? You know, I just came from QT to get me a strawberry limeade. And I'll be goddamn if I wasn't waiting 45 minutes in the hot ass sun for a strawberry limeade. You know why? Because there's only one person in there. One lone white girl, overworked and underpaid. Because it's not just us. It's anybody that they can enslave, including their own people. And it goes deeper than that. When you look at these little subdivision, because this is the way how they got to, you know, spread out their money. And I know people are going to come from my black ass, but I don't care. Because like I said, and I'm going to say it again, I'm going to keep saying it, I'm not here for clicks and likes. Okay? That's not my thing. I don't seek validation outside of self. Never have and never will. So with that being said, the way how they spread out their money, being that the bulk of the money, you know, is kept with a few. And really, they have the money that they can pay somebody at McDonald's $25, $30 an hour. The people that work in the hospital, the housekeeping, that are exposed to all manner of germs and bodily fluids that have to wash thousands of pounds of, you know, hospital bed linen. They don't pay them. The nursing assistants that work their ass off do way more than the nurses. They don't even pay them. The people that clean the hospital floors, the hospital toilets. We don't pay our teachers. We don't pay our police officers. First of all, police officers should be making at least $100,000 a year, tops, to start. And by the time they clock out, at least $300,000. The same for firemen. You know what I'm saying? Our teachers should be getting paid at least $100,000 a year. They're educating our children. But you will take $68 million. This is how they spread out their money. They, you know, the ones that they have to spread out. They get their pets, their tokens, which are your basketball players, your football players, your baseball players. Now, I know Michael Jordan, yes, he could dunk a ball, but at the reality, $100 million contract for what? Running down a court to dunk a ball in a net? I'm not impressed, Okay, football player that get a $68 million contract for 5 years to run down a field with a ball, or a baseballer, whatever the hell they're called, to swing a bat. You know what I'm saying? A baseball player, all these millions of dollars, when that's the money that could be spread out over society to pay people that are working their asses off and not getting paid. I mean, this is ridiculous. And as I look at it, the age of Aquarius, we are really not on our square. And we really need to get together as a collective. And really, I mean, it is going to come to an end. But it's like, when? Because honestly, I'm tired of this shit. It's an ancestral tiredness from my mother to her 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 mother going back. You know what I'm saying? It's like, when? Can you imagine in 2021 grown ass people getting paid $15 an hour? That's something that you give a high school student. And you're talking about come to get a career in McDonald's. Come to get a career in what? That's not a career. That's a job. Because you can't even get a career because, you know, college is so goddamn expensive, and that in itself is a scam. In black and brown communities, they're undereducated. So when they go to school, they got to, you know, 2 years of prerequisites and then another 2 years a year or something before they can go in their field. And when they come out, they still can't get a job. You know what I'm saying? And are thousands, $100,000 in debt. And then, you know, they got you fighting over parties. Democrats, Republicans, right wing, left wing, same friggin' bird. There is no difference who's in power because they're all corrupt. They're not doing nothing. I'm not friggin' impressed. You know what I'm saying? And then you look at this COVID shot. And while I know that COVID exists, who the fuck are you to tell me if I don't take a shot, I can't come to work, I can't have my job? What is this shit? So you're saying you can impose your goddamn will on the people? This shit is no better than North Korea, Russia, China, you know what I'm saying? Where people literally don't have rights. So you claim that this is a democracy, but you know, when you break down the words, democ, what is mock, M-O-C-K, it's a mockery. It really is a mockery. There is no democracy here. How is this supposed to be a free country? A free country. And you are telling me that you can impose a shot. I don't give a shit. So what if I want to drop dead of COVID? What is it? Is it me dropping dead, or is it you that need to be protected? You know what I'm saying? And so everybody got to be vaccinated. I mean, which is it? You know what I'm saying? And so what? People die of disease. We're all going to die sooner or later. I don't see why people are so afraid of death. You understand? It's the principle of being forced. So your livelihood now is being taken away because you don't want to get a shot. Never mind, you know, me, I'm a former healthcare professional. I can tell you how they treat black and brown people in the hospital, which is one of the major reasons I quit. That and the racism, the goddamn Karen nurses, that if I didn't leave, I most certainly would have caught a case. And see, to me, it ain't worth a case for one person. I'll happily go out taking out 10 people and go sit my ass down eating dry ass peanut butter and jelly. It won't be one person. So before that, I'm just throwing one Karen out the window, one racist ass Karen. Let me take my black ass on. I'm just pissed off of how they're forcing this shot on people. So you want to tell me we, the majority, are letting a few impose their will on us, the majority. You know what I'm saying? People have to take this shot or else they lose their job. You know what I'm saying? The hysteria behind it. You know what I'm saying? And there's something worse coming behind COVID. And all people are saying is just this shot that has been rushed out and trotted out. I don't give a shit if it's been approved by the FDA. My mother had open heart surgery, going to the doctors for years, being underdiagnosed. Because again, this is what they do to black and brown. And I'm glad I wasn't in Boston because a lot of people would have got put in that goddamn Ogun pot. I might even caught a case or two that she had been going in all these years. And, oh, it's just heartburn. It's just heartburn, taking x-rays and this. And it was not till she keeled over on her job and had to have open heart surgery immediately. Now they prescribed a prescription for her because she has chronic pain, diabetes with whatever that pain is. I can't remember it right now. That's associated with diabetes and, you know, some other arthritis. You know what I'm saying? And the medicine they give her, this naproxen, regular ass naproxen, that is FDA approved. That if you take this medicine, it can cause heart problems. It can cause heart problems. It can cause cancer. The side effects of the medicine is so ridiculous that it's like it can give you all types of heart problems. It can cause destruction of your heart valve. When she was reading me the side effects, and I'm like, wow, and this shit got passed by the FDA. Don't nobody give a shit about what's passed by the FDA. The FDA pass all kinds of crazy ass drug all the time. You ever listen to some of these commercials and listen to the side effects of some of these drugs that are passed by the FDA? Because this is not about being passed. The pharmaceutical company, okay, who is also owned by these rich white families, okay, that are vested in selling you drugs that cause all kind of diabolical, destructive side effects, that now you need more drugs. With this COVID shot, you know what I'm saying? And I know a couple of people that took it. My mother took it. My 76-year-old mother took it. She's doing fine. But we don't know 3-5 years down the line, what is the after effects? You know what I'm saying? I know one of my clients, my white client, my regular ass client, her husband took the COVID shot. He can't even go outside and mow the lawn anymore because now he has shortness of breath. Now he's having all kinds of stuff. There was a story of one sister that took it and had her arms and her feet amputated. If that's even one person, that's one too many. And we should have the right over our own body, our own autonomy. Who the fuck is the government to force people to get a shot that you don't want? So that means, wait a minute, I'm still a slave. This is some Nazi shit right here. This is, we're not no better than North Korea with Kim Jong-un, how he rolls up on his people. You know what I'm saying? What kind of fuckery is this? And this is supposed to be a democracy? And then you look at these little subdivisions where the wealthy, the uber wealthy, put their money into to have all these subdivisions that's built up. And you look at these houses with no insulation. A friend of mine just bought one of these big, beautiful fake brick house. And already the car, the garage door, the electrical system is all crazy. The pipe burst in, the electrical system, the house has no insulation. In about 10, 20 years, people are going to walk away from this and declare bankruptcy, and it'll be a housing crisis, but not before. The people in those houses are going to get sick because when it starts to rain and it starts to mildew, because it has no insulation and it starts to mold up, the people in those homes are going to be sick. And the government allows this. Who are these builders? You know what I'm saying? Because by the time you get done suing them, they already made their money and gone off somewhere else. This is why a lot of people, you know, aren't moving to Canada and other places. I mean, it's ridiculous. And this small infant empire is going to fall. And it's going to fall on its own wickedness. And see, this is where the age of Aquarius, people are not fully woken up yet. Because if we were fully awakened as a collective, we wouldn't let them get away with stuff like this. Because people are in such fear of losing their little low-paying jobs where they're overworked and underpaid any motherfucking ways. So when they threaten you about getting a shot, who the fuck are they to threaten you to get a shot that you don't want to get? So you're telling me I ain't got control over my body, over my autonomy, that you, the government, can mandate and force me? Where is the democracy? So what's it going to be? Because you have a sister, I can't remember her name off that doctor, doctor something. She, you know, got the head wrap, Maramba or somebody. I can't remember. You know, when you're ready to run and leave this place, it's going to be in a few. You can't even leave here. Because it's like, really, they got their slaves on lock. And they can impose their will. The will, because it's panic for profit. Okay, it's panic for profit. So when everybody is panicking, I'm not panicking about COVID. Shit, fuck it. If I die of COVID, when I had it, I didn't even go to the hospital. Now, I felt like I was dying. I felt like a goddamn baby elephant was sitting on my chest. And I was definitely sick. Okay. My body felt like somebody put me in a goddamn oven. And honestly, I felt like I was going to spontaneously combust. I couldn't even walk. I was crawling to the bathroom. And I was definitely sick for about a good 3 weeks. My mother was definitely sick. She was on a ventilator. And see, here's the thing with a ventilator. It's 50-50. 50% chance you're going to come out of it. 50% chance you won't. And that's okay. It's death. It's only death. But the principle of it, that we have a small minority, and they are in the minority. I don't care how they use the media, because I seen some bullshit the other day talking about the Caucasian race is the majority in this country. Bullshit. That's a flat out lie. If that was the case in the South, the racist-ass South, they wouldn't have to resort to gerrymandering and doing all of this illegal shit so that they can remain in power. The election was stolen from Stacey Abrams by that shady-ass Scorpio Kent from Athens. Okay? I mean, let's keep that shit real. If they were in power, like there was, it wouldn't be no need for all this illegal and backdoor thing. You know what I'm saying? But it's just ridiculous to me. It is just ridiculous how this stuff is unfolding and how people's rights are being dismissed. Where are your rights? Okay, you got us. We wear a mask, and I don't, you know, I carry my mask. My kids know, you know, they go to school with a mask on. I'm not, where are my rights? Yeah, but really, you know what I'm saying? And honestly, if they try to make it mandatory for the kids to go to school, I will be homeschooling my children. You understand? What next? You're going to have to get the COVID shot to apply for Medicaid to get some food stamps? You know what I'm saying? What next? I mean, this shit is ridiculous. And I don't understand the majority. See, this is where the majority of the people are just... And see, the age of Aquarius is a rebellious age, but it's not there yet. Because I guarantee you, my generation is going to be the last generation they'll be able to pimp. Because my son's generation, my grandchildren's generation, oh, they're not here for none of that shit. You won't be able to come at them with none of this. Because first of all, religion is on its last leg. And when that goes, you can hang that shit up. You understand? Because you won't be able to keep them in fear with the, ooh, some guy in hell with horns and a pitchfork bullshit. You know what I'm saying? This is hell right here. And see, here is my thing. I don't begrudge the football, the baseball, and the basketball players their money. I don't begrudge them. But why does somebody need all these millions of dollars to play ball? This is like back in Romans time when they distracted the people with sports. I mean, there's a lot of people that don't watch sports. Hell, I don't watch sports. I could care less. You know what I'm saying? But does a basketball player deserve $60 million? For a 3-year contract to just run down a court and throw a hoop in a ball? Well, come on. An actress getting, what, $30 million for making one movie? I can understand getting some residual. You know, it does good and shit gets some kickback. But you getting $30 million just to make a fucking movie, when really all of this money could be spread out. People in McDonald's should literally be getting at least minimum $25 an hour. But the mother said it's going to be $30 million because I'm telling you, I have never seen so much for hire. You go to McDonald's and try to get a cup of coffee and you sitting there waiting 45 minutes for a cup of coffee. Why? Because there's only two people in there. Dunkin' Donuts, you go to, you know, I mean, really, it's crazy. Even just calling my children's dental office yesterday. I was on the phone for 30 minutes. 30 minutes. I had to hang up and call back, almost ready for a straitjacket. You know what I'm saying? This is what it is, because people are tired. People are tired, and people have got to get more and more tired. And we have got to stand up against this beast. Just little stuff like this. You know what I'm saying? How dare you want to force, impose your will, the will of the minority against the majority? Because all it is panic for profit. Because you take the shot and 3 or 5 years later, and I know they'll probably shadow ban this video. I don't give a shit. 3 to 5 years later, you know, you develop some rare form of cancer. Or you develop all kind of health problems that you never had before. You start getting blood clots and, you know, things with your heart and your lungs and all of this. Now you need all these medicines to keep you alive. No, these are crimes against humanity. I don't give a shit if you think this shot is safe or if you think it's for the betterment. It should be left up to the people. The people should decide if they want to take this shot. Because you always have enough of the sheeps that'll fall for the fucking scam. You know what I'm saying? And take the shot. Hey, if you die of COVID, you die of COVID. You get COVID, you can recover. It depends. You understand? Because part of this is also spiritual. You understand? And it doesn't mean that, oh, spiritual people get COVID, they're not going to die. No, that don't mean a goddamn thing. You understand? The earth is also cleansing herself on top of the man-made diseases and viruses that are being made in labs and unleashed on people. Because don't think we don't have germ warfare that are being fought. I mean, look at back in the day with the natives, the indigenous, putting the smallpox in the blankets and giving to the people. And you trust these people? You trust these people? You know what I'm saying? Who are they? It's a minority at the top. And I'm tired of these descendants of former slave masters and colonialists imposing their will on the majority. And this is where the occultists, okay, the collective need to get together, okay? Because then you have the super rich, like that idiot Elon Musk. He's going to make a robot. The fuck we need a robot for? Who cares about a goddamn robot? What you going to do with a robot? I live here in Atlanta, Georgia, in Conyers. They're building up a brand new mall on 138. For what? The pay rate down here is $13 an hour, $14 an hour. The car dealership, the Honda dealership, just went out of business. They had to break it all down. You know why? Because y'all had that car and out of greed. Y'all could have been selling them cars, but no. Somebody like me that come in that need a new car, guess what? I've never had a credit card. I've never filed for bankruptcy. I've never had a repossession. But because I don't have a credit card, you know what I'm saying? You want to give me a car, okay, with a 20% interest rate. 20% interest rate. Okay, the car I got now is a 17% interest rate. My other car, the Dodge Durango that I paid off in 4 years, that I had a 26 interest rate. 26, and I know I paid for that car like three times over. This is the kind of wickedness that they do. So you know what? Your malls are going to go out of business. You understand? We're going to curse all your motherfucking malls, all your car dealership. You understand? You're not going to be able to stand on the unrighteous wickedness that you're doing. This is why you work with Saturn. Because let me tell you something, honey. Saturn will bust down some shit in a minute. You understand? Desperdas enemigos míos. Et Saturnia nomen. You know what I'm saying? In Saturn's name. Et Saturnia nomen. It's ridiculous. And the whole time that dealership been sitting there, people done went on the lot and tried to get cars. They don't want to give the people cars. And them cars sitting out there, well, guess what? Now they all rotted out. And guess what? Your dealership went out of business because ain't nobody getting nothing. And then, because see, this is like the uber rich, the super rich. They sit back and they watch. This shit is like Game of Thrones down here. Well, we just going to pay them $13 an hour and watch them struggle to live from check to check, but still go in the mall and buy useless shit. Where you getting the money from? Where you getting the money from? You know what I'm saying? And in this day of Aquarius, I curse your fucking malls. I curse your car dealership. I curse all of your wicked enterprises that's sitting up here feeding on the people like parasites. And see, this is where the occult is. Now, you want some shit to put your energy towards? That's some shit to put your energy towards. You understand? Really, if you want to shift some shit and put your energy towards. You see how Steve Jobs, he died of cancer. You know what I'm saying? The rest of the super rich that treat people like crap. You got that cockeyed Bezos. You know how he treat the Amazon workers, working them like death. You know what I'm saying? They can't even pull over to take a piss. You know what I'm saying? Because it's like everybody got to be on time. No. When are we going to be tired of this? I know I've been tired of this shit. I've been tired of it. At what point do we, the majority, get tired of this? Because it is a small minority all over the globe that just have everybody enslaved. Slavery never ended. It got rebranded. It got a new face put on it. You know what I'm saying? And lulled you into thinking that you have rights now, that, you know, you're under democracy. You tell me a government in a so-called country like America forcing a vaccine on people. I don't give a fuck if the FDA passed the vaccine. Who cares? Who cares about the FDA? The FDA passed plenty of drugs that kill people. That ain't nothing. You know what I'm saying? If this was a case and you really cared about people, cigarettes would not be openly sold because cigarettes do kill people. Alcohol kill people. My mother's neighbor is dying of liver cancer because he's an alcoholic, but it's sold openly. You know what I'm saying? So let's not act like you really care about the people. This is about your agenda. And you having the slaves still in, you're still enslaved. You're still enslaved if a government can force a vaccine on you. I don't care if you feel like you can get up and go on an airplane. The mere fact that they can force a vaccine, and it is not your will. It is not your will. You know, it said, thy will be done on earth, fiat voluntas tuentera. You know what I'm saying? Thy will be done on earth. Your will is not done on earth because you got a minority at the top, a scant minority who imposes their will on you. I don't give a shit about Dr. Fauci, whatever the hell his name is. You know what I'm saying? Who the hell are you? Okay? And this is where, you know, the collective energy, but it hasn't reached critical mass yet. Because, and when it does reach critical mass, you understand? Because, see, what they don't understand, it's a tiredness that has come down from generation to generation. It's an ancestral tiredness. I feel the weight of my ancestors and their ancestors and their ancestors of the inequality, the brutality, the wickedness, the propaganda, the mockery of democracy. You know what I'm saying? It's just no freedom, no freedom. You know what I'm saying? Imagine your own body, your own, this is your temple. And you don't have autonomy over your temple. A government can impose its will on your temple. And we're not rising up enough like we should. You know what I'm saying? So on that note, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, share, and subscribe. Apparently, I've been forgetting to say that at the end of every video. And I will be doing a live stream for my subscribers this weekend. Come with your pen and your paper and your questions. I will be doing free readings, okay? So until next time. Same bat time, same bat channel. All right.